I'm going to show you a few simple stretches that you can do if you suffer from sciatica. So the sciatic nerve runs all the way down the back of your leg. And you can do this with or without a chair. And the feet at least hip width apart. Try and have both legs straight. You can use a chair if you need to. You're going to try and straighten both legs out. Really pull up the thigh muscles, the kneecaps. So engage your legs. Scoop your belly in. So you can find that point so you feel a stretch all the way down the back of your leg. Push your heels into the floor. And you can hold for several breaths. I would recommend doing your bad leg first. And then switching. And doing your good side. So your bad leg will be the back leg. And so if you can, if you're flexible enough, you can come all the way down for a stronger stretch. Spin the chair around, come a little bit lower. The lower you are, the stronger your stretch is. So do a couple of breaths on your bad leg, switch legs, and then go back and do another couple of breaths on your bad leg. Make sure you're breathing deeply, because when you first start, it might be a little bit painful, so you might hold the breath. So keep breathing deeply. And you can hold that for as long as you like. Now with a good stretch for the back of the leg. And you can use a chair or something. Flex the foot. It doesn't matter if you can't straighten the leg. I recommend bending the knee enough so that you can hold on the back of the chair. Scoop your belly in and then start to try and straighten the leg. Now that's too strong, you can inhale, bend, exhale, straighten. Inhale, bend, exhale, straighten. But keep that foot flexed. And as you straighten the leg, firm up your thigh muscles. And again, that'll get the stretch all the way down the back of the leg. Again, do both sides. Do your bad side first, then your good side. And then switch to your bad side again. Another one, you can come down onto the floor. Move the flesh away from the sit bones. Bend one knee and bring the foot inside of that thigh. You can be a little bit further down if you need to. Try and think of pressing that knee down towards the floor. Scoop your belly in. And think of hinging forward. You can, if you can reach your toes, great. If not, wrap a belt or towel or something around that foot and try and hinge yourself forward. At the same time, think of pressing that knee down towards the floor. And again, you should get up into that sciatic nerve. Again, hold for 4 or 5 breaths, as long as you can manage. And you'll notice after a couple of breaths that it will become easier. Again, make sure you do both sides, and you will notice that one side feels a bit easier than the other. But try and make sure you move the flesh away from the sit bones so you're not hunched over. Again, it doesn't matter if you can't reach your toes, press that other knee down. Again, pull that foot towards you, or at least flex that foot towards you. That also helps protect your knee joints, and stretch it out. Another one, come onto your knees. You can open your knees out a little bit and rest your head on the floor. If you're not comfortable with the head on the floor, you can turn it slightly to one side and relax your arms. Just relax your arms down into child's pose. And that helps gently stretch out all the muscles in your back as well. Again, you can stay there literally for a couple of minutes if you want to. And it'll help all those tense muscles in your back release. Pause the video and stay there for as long as you like. And take the legs wide again, flex the feet, and just try and hinge forward. Hinge forward and back. Exhale forward. Inhale as you come up. And flex your feet to protect your knee joints. And try and reach a little bit further each time. And exhale as you reach forward. Inhale as you come up, keeping your tummy pulled in super tight. Stretch all the muscles again down the backs of your legs. Bring the legs in, take one leg across, and really imagine drawing that leg across the body as you turn your belly button around. And again, that gets the nerves in the backs of your legs, also stretches out your back muscles. Spinal twists are fantastic, absolutely, for anything. And keep this foot flexed. And if you can't reach your arm across, just use the hand. Think of drawing the knee across as you're trying to turn your belly. Or you can take the arm to the outside. Press that arm against the knee. Try not to lean on your back hand. Again, do both sides. You can hold them for much longer than I'm showing you here. Literally giving you a quick demonstration. And I would recommend doing them a couple of times each side. So you can hold them for as long as you like, do them a couple of times each side. Another good one is to rock and roll. Massages your spine. Don't go too far back, so you don't want the head to touch the floor. Massage your spine. Make sure you're on a softer surface so that you don't hurt your back. And when you've done that, massage the area. Loose fist. Massage along your thumb muscles. It'll help to loosen up the muscles. Again, do both sides. You can do this sitting. You can do this with your legs out straight. You can do it like that. Again, nice loose fist. You're not trying to beat yourself up. Just trying to relax the muscles. When we come in pain, everything tenses and cramps. So you're just trying to loosen it off. Loosen off the tension. Awesome. Thanks for watching.